part of God's body. And I can't make it without you. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Why don't you look around the room and just tell somebody you are important to me. Look around the room and say, you are important to me. And I need you to survive. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Present your somebody. Unto God. Which is, the Bible says, your reasonable service. And the church said, hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Okay, well then I'm going to say that again. I said, come on and let's give God some praise. I know what we're doing here today, but we still want to worship and give God what's due him in the name of Jesus. I know we got to stay in order and everybody got their collars on and they suits on, but you got to remember that you was just a dirty, filthy rag, and God decided that he was going to call you and he was going to clean you up for his glory. I don't know why they be trying to give me the mic and telling me that they want me to come and they want me to do praise and worship, because when I begin to think about how good God has been to me, I just want to kind of cut up and act up. The voice is just about gone, but I say hallelujah for the voice that I actually do have. There's somebody out there who ain't got no voice. There's some people out there that ain't got no hand to do this. There's some people out there that don't have a foot so they can do back with some of us. You know, when you first got saved and it just was the hands and the feet and it wasn't no music because the music was down on the inside. We get so reliant on if the CD don't work. If the guitar player ain't here, if the keyboard ain't here, if the drums ain't here, but God is here, you gotta have him down on the inside of you. That should be the only music and the only song that you need. Bishop Blackwell, why they give me the mic? Why they give me the mic? Okay, that's what I'm doing. I'm telling them about Jesus. So I'm supposed to just go through a little praise and worship. Are y'all ready for some praise and some worship? That true kind of praise and worship, not the surface stuff, but that stuff that's down on the inside. On the inside. You know, we was here this past weekend. Bishop Brown, I'm really, really hoarse. But I was sitting at his desk, because he's such a gracious man. And I began to sing this song, and he said, "Sister," and he called me sister sometimes. He said, "You gonna sing that song Sunday?" I say, "I don't know." And then he gave me another look like, "Well, I'm not really asking you, but could you sing that song on Sunday?" So, you know, we all know this song. We all have been in that place, and we always be complaining. And God be telling us, don't complain. But we still be complaining about, "God, we ain't got the right shoes. We ain't got the right clothes to put on today." Or you go to the cabinet, and our children are good about this. They go to the refrigerator and say, "We ain't got nothing to eat." You need to say that, but something in there that you want to eat, but there's some food to eat. Y'all know we do that about clothes. They ain't got nothing to wear. I got two closets and two racks inside the garage at my house. I'm talking walk-in closets. And I be hollering about, "I ain't got nothing to wear." So God wants us to stop complaining. He wants us just to think about how good he has been to us. How he just decided he called some of us and he chose us. Some of us he elected for offices. But when I think about it, Pastor Brown, you know, you've had some good days. You've had some hills to climb. You've had some weary days and some lonely nights. But when I look around the question, Lord, why so much pain, for he knows what's best for me. My weary eyes, they can't see, but I'll say thank you, Lord. I'll just say thank you, Lord. And I won't complain. God's been good to me. He's been so good to me. More than this whole world could ever see. He's been good to me, yeah. He dried all my tears away and turned my midnight into day. But I'll say thank you, Lord. I'll just say thank you, Lord. Pastor Brown, when he don't come to church, you just say thank you, Lord. When people complain that you're not doing it the way that they think you should do it, you just don't have to complain. It says, I won't complain. Because God's been good to me. He's been so good to me. More than this whole world could ever see. And I'll just say thank you, Lord. 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 And I won't complain. Hallelujah. Come on, let's give God some praise. Somebody out there might be saying, why she sang that song and she knows she whored? It wasn't unto you, it was unto God. I'm gonna praise and worship God. It ain't about you. If you didn't like the way that it sounded, and so be it. You ain't God and I don't serve you. I serve God himself. God said, let everything that have breath praise the Lord. And I got some breath in me. It might be hoarse, it might be sore, but it's unto the Lord everything that I do. Deacon, let's come on and give them some more music and see whether they're really ready here to praise and worship God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. You say you don't have to worry. You don't have to worry.
Two, three. That's all I want everybody to do. If I can get everybody to rock with me. Everybody rock with me. Come on, everybody rock with me. Everybody rock with me. Come on. Come on. Lift your hand in there. Lift your hand in there and rock with me. There you go. There you go. There you go. There you go. Listen. New York, there are a lot of people out there hurting nowadays.
You know. Sometimes we have to go and take some stuff and do some stuff.
A lot of these children have been raised and don't even know who they are.
This ain't even the right song. But hallelujah anyhow. Hallelujah anyhow. Minister Eric. Hallelujah anyhow. All right, Deacon, let's go for the next one. And then I'm going to have y'all put, they said two heads is better than one. So y'all better get it together because y'all don't want Pastor to come to the back.
Amen.
Hallelujah. 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 We ain't gonna give the enemy no room in here today. Hallelujah. 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 He's trying to start working already. Come on, y'all. Hallelujah. 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 Let's let him know you got to get up out of him. You can't stand in the house. You can't sit by me. You can't sit in front of me. You can't even sit behind me. You can't walk inside the door. We don't care where he go, but he gonna get up out of here. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. What God has for me, it is for me. What God has for me, it is for me. I know without a doubt that he will bring me out. What God has for me, it is for me.
Or she might need to doctor on somebody. Because when we get sick sometimes, God wants us to come into this house and see the doctor. And see the doctor. But we'd be too busy sometimes trying to see some other doctors, like Dr. Feelgood, a doctor mix a little bit up in here and stick it up under the pillow kind of doctors. Y'all know what I'm talking about. Don't look at me like that. You know what I'm talking about. I'm just real, Bishop Hart. Hallelujah. Y'all got it working together back there? I got a shaking head. I think they say no. All right. We're going to turn it over to Tyler. You got a voice. Come on, brother. Let's minister to him.
Thank you.
Direct us to set aside a time for reflecting. On one occasion, we were told to give thanks at the remembrance of our salvation. Again, we were enjoined to remember his benefits toward us. Our gathering for this worship service is to again reflect. Our thoughts today are of the suffering, shame, and rejection our Lord endured for our redemption. Not only did he suffer these pains, he also suffered the heartbreak of betrayal. Society and our church further used this occasion to honor individuals who have come to be recognized as servants of mankind. This recognition is not easily achieved. I don't think that Pastor Brown said back when he was in the military that one day, I want to be a mission. He no doubt said, like every other leader, I ain't gonna be that. Y'all know, okay, for those of you who want me to say it the right way, some of y'all might say, well, I am not. But some of y'all from the East Coast, from the dirty, dirty, say, I ain't whatever it is. Ain't that right, Dr. Blackwell? All right, I'm just making it plain so everybody can get a little piece of it. It says this recognition, again, is not easily achieved, nor should it be. Rather, it must always come as a result of hard work coupled with diligence, perseverance, compassion, sincerity, unselfishness, and hard work. I think that's Fred Brown. I've seen the man be diligent. I've seen him persevere when it wasn't nobody. He was doing it himself. I've seen compassion, him giving his shirt to somebody else. I see the sincerity when he do the things that he do. He don't do it for somebody to go and say, he did it. He did it because of the God that's in him. It says unselfishness. Pastor Burrell yesterday did a testimony about having some place to worship at. We all came to Pastor Brown because we needed a place to worship. And he said, I don't know what he said. Well, I know what he said to you, Pastor Burrell, because you said it yesterday. But he said, sister. And he got a way of saying sister.
He said, as long as you're doing the work of the Lord, you are welcome here. He said, but when you stop, we got a problem. That's unselfishness. He said, don't worry about no money. You know, we'll talk about it. Come on, come on. Let's all just get in here. His vision is bigger than anyone could imagine. And his vision is just not a selfish vision just for himself. That's why it says unselfishness. It said this honor is not normally bestowed upon those who are without experience, or newcomers, rather. It is usually the person who has seen many battles and has been victorious in all. I know Pastor Brown has seen many battles, naturally and spiritually. Sometimes our bigger battles is with ourselves. Yes. And the people that's closest around us, like sometimes family. That's the biggest battles that we gotta fight. When you're trying to juggle Pastor Brown, the pastor, and trying to juggle Pastor Brown, the husband, Pastor Brown, the father, Pastor Brown, the son, Pastor Brown, the confidant, he had to go through some stuff that he can learn how to balance it all. He ain't perfect. So if he ain't got it right, he getting it right. If he got some stuff where the scale might be tipped, he getting it right. I believe that with everything that's in me. And if he don't get it right, then I done signed on the paper, we going to have some problems. I'm going to get with him. But he going to get it right. I believe that. It says, likewise, those who are elevated to the bishopric in the new Christ Supernatural Temple of Deliverance Church are being rewarded for having actually become servants of the Lord and his church, and for having displayed the ability to adequately lead the Lord's sheep as under shepherds. May God add to the wisdom, strength, compassion, and humility of this son of our Lord's church, who shall be consecrated to the holy office of the bishop. God bless you.
A lot of us look at natural seasons as winter, spring, summer, and fall. But today we are embracing a pivotal time, a pivotal season for the man of God. Can you just look at your neighbor and say, I think he's talking about new season. The Bible says, in due season ye shall reap if you faint not. But to know that the race is not given to the swift. The battle the pastor was talking about is not given to the strong. But it's given unto the one that knows how to endure. And the only way you can endure is by leaning and depending on him. Leaning and depending on him. And every aspect of life and everything that you do, everything that you say, it can only work and be successful if you're leaning and depending on him. Hallelujah. Is that a witness? Is that a witness? Leaning and depending on him is what will get you through. Hallelujah. Because I couldn't have made it without him. Some of the stuff that you are facing in your life, you know that you could not have made it had not you been dependent upon Jesus. Some of the habits that you could not break on your own could not have been obtained had you not been leaning and depending on a man named Jesus. Some of the storms that you have encountered in this life, you could not have made it had not you been dependent upon the man named Jesus. Some of the restless seas of time that have crept upon life's courses that have been designed for you, you could not have had peace in the midst of the storm had not you been dependent upon Jesus. I'm reminded of a woman that was thirsty and she did not know where to find satisfaction. She went from vessel to vessel to vessel to vessel until one day she ran upon the vessel at the well. And the well, the man that was sitting at the well said, if you really knew who I was, if you really knew who I was, they might look like me. I know you've been with other vessels that might have something on the inside, but they were not like me. Jesus says, if you knew who I was, I'd give you something to drink. And this that I have, you will never. He said, you will never thirst again. Hallelujah. I'm so glad today that we have partook of that cup, that we can face eternal life. Brothers and sisters, I declare unto you, hallelujah, you may not know what happened yesterday. It might be blurry what happened yesterday. The things that are going on right now may be a little out of focus. But I guarantee you tomorrow, the songwriter says, we'll understand it better by and by. Hallelujah. We're understanding better by and by. Hallelujah. Because I know a man that sits high and looks low. Hallelujah. He holds the world in the palm of his hand. And he says, behold, I come in the volume of a book. And they said the book was open, and he gave the book to the ministers. And he says, you teach them as I have taught you. At this time, the ministry of the word of God, we're going to ask the greatest pastor of Greater Faith Outreach Ministry, the greatest pastor that sits upon that foundation and has been given a key of life, Pastor Elizabeth Hamilton, would you come and share the word of God?
Yes. trees of righteousness.
Hallelujah. I'm going to get to the scripture. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. We'll be coming out of Isaiah 61. This is what it's all about. And I thank God for you, Bishop. First Lady, for pressing your way. God's got a blessing in it for you. Beautiful couple. Thank you, Jesus. The Spirit of the Lord is upon me because the Lord has anointed me to preach good tidings to the poor. He has sent me to heal the brokenhearted, to proclaim liberty to the captives, and to opening of the prison of those who are bound, to proclaim the acceptable year of the Lord and the day of vengeance of our Lord, to comfort all who mourn, to console those who mourn in Zion, to give them beauty for ashes, the oil of joy for mourning, the garment of praise for the spirit of heaviness, that they may be called trees of righteousness, hallelujah. The planting of the Lord, that he may be glorified. So when we raise up trees of righteousness for the Lord's sake, he's glorified. And that's what it's all about. And they shall rebuild the old ruins. They shall rise up, raise up the former desolation. And they shall repair the ruined cities, the desolation of many generations. Many generations. Strangers shall stand and feed your flock. And the sons of the foreigners shall be your plowmen. And your vineyards and your vine dressers, but you shall be named the priests of the Lord. They shall call you the sons of our God. You shall eat the riches of the Gentiles, and their glory you shall boast. Instead of your shame, you shall have double honor, and instead of confusion, they shall rejoice in their portion. Therefore, in their land, they shall possess double. Everlasting joy shall be theirs. Hallelujah. That's something to shout about. Let's give God a big hand of glory for his word. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Everlasting. This is not it, folks. This is not it. Everlasting joy. Thank you, Jesus. So I just want to thank God for the hearing, the reading, and the receiving of his word.
Praise the Lord, saints of God. 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 This is the day which the Lord hath made. We will rejoice and be glad in it. I was glad when they said unto me, come, let us go into into the house of the Lord. Amen. No matter what it looks like on the outside, we got Jesus on the inside. And that's all that matters. And that's all right with me. Amen.
Amen.
Giving honor to God, who's the head of my life. Giving honor to our Savior, Lord, and King Jesus Christ, the King of kings, the Lord of lords. Giving honor to the Holy Spirit, the blessed third person, a part of the blessed Holy Triune. Giving honor to the shepherd and the honor of this particular celebration and occasion. Bishop, giving honor to the first lady of the house. Giving honor to the bishops in the pulpit. Bishop Blackwell, we'll know your name, Bishop Smith. Giving honor to our overseer, Apostle Adams. Giving honor to Apostle Micah. Giving honor to Pastor Wachita. Giving honor to the pastors in the audience. Giving honor to the evangelists, the ministers, the prophetess, the fivefold. Giving honor to the saints of God. Even giving honor to the children and the household. Generation excellent. Giving honor to all whom honor is due. I praise and bless and glorify God for you, and I'm humbled, honored, and privileged to be a part of such a momentous occasion. And I will be coming before you with the reading of the word coming from the book of 1 Peter, the 5th chapter, verses 1 through 4. And after that, I will be reading a portion in the booklet for those of you that have it. I will be reading as the lector, and I ask that you respond as the people. Amen?
Amen.
Going with the reading. The elders which are among you, I exhort, who am also an elder and a witness of the sufferings of Christ, and also a partaker of the glory that shall be revealed. Feed the flock of God, which is among you, taking the oversight thereof, not by constraint, but willingly, not for filthy lucre, but of a ready mind, neither as being lords over God's heritage, but being examples of to the flock. And when the chief shepherd shall appear, ye shall receive a crown of glory that fadeth not. That reading for you, Bishop. And giving God praise, honor, and glory. You know, this is a time of celebration. You know, the word said for us to weep with those that weep and to rejoice with those that rejoice. You know, it's a strange thing for me when we see others that God is exhorting, because he said, humble ourselves under the mighty hand of God, and he will exalt us in due season. You know, it's a strange thing that I've seen out in the world, even in the household of faith. When God raised somebody else up, we have haters. We have haters. But please look at your neighbor to the left and look at your neighbor to the right and repeat that said, let's not hate. Can we just celebrate? Yeah, let's celebrate what God is doing in a man of God's life, because he is family, and God is raising up family, and we rejoice when God is raising up, and we celebrate family on today. Yeah, in the name of Jesus. I call myself out. We go into the lecture, reading of the word. I have my seat afterwards. And it reads. How many of us know the word? We need the word. 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 He said, my words are spirit and they are life. We need the word. He said, my word goes forth and return not unto me void, but accomplish that thing whereunto I send it, that which I please. That thing shall prosper. And we need the word. We need the word. The word of the Lord. People,
you, Jesus. Thank 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 you, Jesus, for your word.
Does not have a book. Okay. They're asking for a $10 donation. If you don't have a $10 donation, make a donation. And you need a book. That's fine? Okay, who needs a book? Pull out a donation. I don't know what your donation is, but pull out a donation. Who's collecting the donation? Okay. And give it to who it needs to go to. We don't want these books to sit in a box and collect meal bills. Not to make money, but to help cover the expense of the printing. Okay? Now, did everybody get a book that had a donation? Okay. Now, who really, 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 really wanted a book and you know you do not have nothing to give? Who really wanted a book and you don't have nothing to give? Raise your hand. Okay, take care of that person and give them a book. For the adults. Okay. Now, those of you sitting in the audience, you see that these people that wanted a book and did not have a donation at all to give? If God has moved upon your heart to give a donation for that person, hold that donation up. That's you sowing a seed into somebody else's life. Some more donations being lifted in the back. The blessings of the Lord be upon you. I feel the spirit of love in this house. There's some more donations being lifted up front. The blessings of the Lord be upon you. Don't you feel that love in this room? Hallelujah. That's a beautiful thing when you can share with somebody else.
Yeah.
Hallelujah to God. And when you get home, you read through these books, read through these obituaries, and learn the life of the pastor, the first lady, and see the awesome work that even she's doing. All right? She's just not sitting still knitting together quilts and blankets. Because I said, I need to get to know this lady. God has birthed ministry even in her. Praise the Lord that she's raising up families and children, giving them strong foundation. Hallelujah. The congregation has been served. Now back to our scheduled program. Hallelujah. Put your hands together and give God some praise. This time, we're going to travel over and experience some more of this apostolic anointing. Right.
from the Evangelical Apostolic Assembly. Put your hands together for Pastor Carolyn Burrell.
Bishop Curtis Montgomery always says that little boys don't throw rocks at empty trees. We talked about the trees of righteousness, the planting of the Lord, that he might be glorified. Hallelujah. There's something in here there's something in you too. I'm not up here for that, but the devil is a liar. The devil is a liar. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. The devil is a liar. What God has joined together. I don't care how it felt or what they said or what they did. If God allowed it, he doesn't sleep, he doesn't slumber. If God allowed it, hallelujah, he wanted it to be so. Thank you, God. Beautiful couple, beautiful anointing, beautiful work. I'm going to get to the scripture. Thank you, Jesus. I didn't get up here to say nothing, just read the scripture. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, God. The devil comes not but to steal, to kill, and to destroy. What God says, I come that you might have life and that you might have it more abundantly.
Glory to God. say it is so. I need you all to repeat after me and say, so it is. It is so, and so it is. God bless you, people of God. Now, before the feast of the Passover, when Jesus knew that his hour was come and that he should depart out of this world unto the Father, having loved his own which were in the world, he loved them unto the end. And supper being ended, the devil having put into the heart of Judas Iscariot, Simon's son, to betray him, Jesus, knowing that the Father had given all things unto his hand and that he was come from God and went to God, he raised from supper and laid aside his garment and took a towel and girded himself. After that, he poured water into a basin and began to wash the disciples' feet and to wipe them with the towel wherewith he was girded. Then cometh he to Simon Peter, and Peter said unto him, Lord, dost thou wash my feet? Jesus answered and said unto him, what I do thou knowest not now, but thou shalt know hereafter. Peter said unto him, thou shalt never wash my feet. Jesus answered him, if I wash thee not, thou hast no part with me. Simon Peter said unto him, Lord, not my feet only, but also my hands and my head. So after he had washed their feet and had taken his garments and was set down again, he said unto them, know ye what I have done to you? Ye call me Master and Lord, and ye say well, for so I am. If I then, your Lord and Master, have washed your feet, ye also ought to wash one another's feet. For I have given you an example that ye should do as I have done to you. Verily, verily, I say unto you, The servant is not greater than his Lord, neither is he that is sent greater than he that sent him. If ye know these things, happy are ye if ye do them. This is the word of the Lord.
Of this song. Just one verse,
Precious Lord.
My feet.
lead you. Every day is not going to be sun shining, but you got to know that the sun is still shining. It may not be sun shining, but you got to know that the sun is still shining. Says that weeping may endure for a time. Only 12 hours. But joy. But joy. But joy. Say that again. She said, joy, joy, joy. Bishops, amen. Our elders, amen. They have a lot to account for. And so their responsibilities are endless. To our bishop and to our pastor, Brown, your responsibilities to pastor or shepherd God's church is to feed, lead, guide, and nurture according to Acts 20 chapter, verse 28, 1 Peter 5 and 2. You are to demonstrate or rule God's church as God has given you the authority. 1 Timothy 5 and 17 and Titus 1 and 5 has justified that, that you may continue to walk, amen, and rule as the Spirit of God have given you the unction to teach and preach, to represent the church at all times, to pray for the sick. And on this day, we are honored in this great city to have these fellow bishops stand with me in this role of the qualifications, because one must be blameless. The husband of one wife. He must be temperate, sober-minded, of good behavior, hospitable, able to teach, not given to wine. Thank you, Jesus. Not violent, but gentle. Not greedy for money. Not quarrelsome. In other words, issues and drama cannot follow holy men and women of God. Not coverings. We go to one church, see something they got, we got to have it. That's not the Spirit of God.
rules his own house well. Amen?
Amen.
You put the devil in check on that one, on this day. Amen? Has submissive children. Amen? And has definitely a mighty testimony. God bless you. With these qualifications, amen, not self-willed, not quick-tempered, a lover of what is good, and a lover of one wife. I like that one. Just, holy, and well self-controlled. Amen? Amen. At this time, our examination, I have asked on this day our bishop if they would stand. Brethren, you have been chosen by God, and the people have confirmed their trust in you by claiming your election, and no man takes his honor unto himself, according to Hebrews, the 5th chapter, 5, verses 4 through 6. A bishop on God's holy ground is called to be one with the apostles, and claiming Christ's resurrection and interpreting the gospel, and to testify to God's sovereign of Lord of Lords and King of Kings. You are called to guard the faith, unite with and disciplined of the church, to celebrate and to provide for the administration of the orders of the new covenant, to ordain pastors, elders, deacons, and to join ordaining bishops, and to be in all things a faithful pastor and a wholesome example for the entire flock of Christ. With your fellow bishops on this great day, you will share in the leadership of the church throughout the world. Your heritage is the faith with the prophets, apostles, those that have led the way, and those of other, of every generation who have looked to God in hope. Your joy will be to follow him who came not to be served, but to serve, and to give his life a ransom for many. We have some questions. I'm going to start, and we will go around. Are you persuaded that God has called you to the office of the bishop?
I am so persuaded.
Will you accept this call and faithful this trust in obedience to Christ?
I will accept this call and fulfill this trust in obedience to Christ.
Will you be faithful in prayer and in the study of the Holy Scriptures, that you may have the mind of Christ?
I will, for the Lord is my help. Will you boldly proclaim and interpret the
gospel of Christ, enlightening the mind, and stirring up the conscience of your people.
I will, in the power of the Holy Spirit.
Will you share with your fellow bishops and the government of the whole church? Will you sustain the fellow presbyter, and take counsel with them? Will you guide and strengthen the deacons and all other who minister in the church?
I will, by the grace given to me.
Will you be merciful to all? Show compassion to the poor and strangers, and defend those whom have no helper?
I will, for the sake of Jesus, our Lord.
Are you persuaded that the Holy Scripture contains sufficiently in all doctrines requires of necessity of eternal salvation through faith in Jesus Christ? And are you determined out of the same Holy Scripture to instruct the people committed to your charge and to teach and maintain nothing as required of necessity to eternal salvation, but which you shall be persuaded may be concluded and proved by the same?
I am persuaded and so determined by God's grace.
Are you ready with faithful diligence to banish and drive all erroneous and strange doctrine contrary to God's word, and both privately and openly to call upon the encouraging of others to do the same?
I am ready, the Lord being my helper.
Will you maintain and set forward as much as shall lie in you quietness, love, and preach among all people, such as shall be unquiet, disobedient, and criminal, correct and punish according to such authority as you have by God's word, and as shall be committed unto you?
I will do so by the help of God.
Amen. Frederick Brown, through these promises you have committed on this day to yourself and to God and to the witness of these people, to serve his church in the office of the bishop, we therefore call upon you, chosen, to be the guardian of the church, faith to us in confessing that faith.
Okay, repeat after me, church. I believe in God.
I believe in God.
The Father Almighty.
The Father Almighty.
Maker of heaven and earth.
Maker of heaven and earth.
And in Jesus Christ.
And in Jesus Christ.
And his Son.
And his Son.
Our Lord.
Who has conceived
of the Holy Ghost,
born of the Virgin Mary,
suffered under Pontius Pilate,
was crucified,
dead and buried.
He descended into hell.
The third day,
he
rose again from the dead.
He ascended into heaven
and sits at the right hand
of God.
The Father Almighty.
The Father Almighty.
From this he shall
come to judge
the quick and the dead.
I believe in the Holy Ghost.
The Holy Apostolic Church.
The
communion of saints.
The
forgiveness of sin.
The
resurrection of the body.
And
life everlasting.
Amen.
as we prepare. Deaconesses, will you come down? Sacred part. You need to come over more so he can hear straight. Bishop, you sleep good. You good? Okay. Lay down. Just lay it down, y'all, so he can lay on it. He has to lay straight. Okay. Thank you, daughters. Face down. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done. Earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us of our debts and our debtors. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from all evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory from this point. Amen.
God of all comfort, dwelling on high, but having regard for the lowly, knowing all things before they come to pass. We give you thanks that from the beginning you have gathered and prepared a people to be heirs of the covenant of Abraham, and have raised up prophets, kings, priests, and ministers, never leaving your temple unattended. We praise you also from the creation you have graciously accepted this ministry of those whom you have given.
We pray that the Spirit, the anointing of wisdom, the anointing of understanding, the anointing of counsel, the anointing of unity, rest upon him. And as he operates in those anointings, you said if we decree a thing, it shall be established. So today we decree, we establish that burdens shall be removed and yokes shall be destroyed as he imparts in the lives of others. In the name of Jesus, we decree as we lay hands upon him that the power of God will move not only in his life, but whatsoever he put his hands to. God, we thank you now. We give you praise. Give you glory. We give you honor. Hallelujah. And because of the anointing in his life, the words that he speaks shall be words that give life. In Jesus' name, amen.
sound that you heard in your hearing, beloved. It's blown by the shofar. It's blown to get your attention, to let you know that something great is about to take place. The sound that you heard also represents the clarion call of an almighty God. He has one sound, and it only comes from him. The scripture says, my sheep know my voice, and a stranger they will not follow. When you seek the Lord, you continue to seek him with your whole heart as to how to govern his people. And when he begins to speak, he speaks with a clarion call. And it makes it so plain that when you begin to write the vision that God has given you, the Bible says that when the people read it, they will see the simplicity of it, and they will have no problem running with it. Hallelujah. The cassock.
The cincture, the casket, the role of a servant modeled after the garment that Jesus wore. This is the garment that they sent, gambled over as he hung on the cross.
Fasten all of these buttons. Because from morning until night, you have been placed in a position to help cover and guard the man of God. You are the one that's closer to him, with the exception of his spouse. And you may know some of the ins and outs of him, more so than anybody in the congregation. But just as you are buttoning him up and covering him now, in prayer, you will do the same thing on a daily basis. Each one of these buttons represent a different phase of life, a different phase of an anointing, a different phase of character. And in every phase of his life, he needs to know that there's somebody that's interceding on his behalf. And everybody may not intercede for you every day, but this charge we give to those that you have chosen, that have presented themselves holy and faithful.
The cincture.
The cincture, which is a belt.
Being placed around his waist, is symbolic of the towel with which Jesus girded himself and began to wash the disciples.
The man of God, the part of him that the congregation can't see. But in the midnight hours when he needs to cry, there's a help me that helps him to hold it together. And as she helps to put it together,
She then takes her rib that was originally taken from him, and she covers it all.
Symbolic of the prophet. In Elijah's day, they called it the prophet's mantle. You knew it immediately that he was God's messenger. As the priest carries the prayers of the people to God, the prophet carries the word of God back to the people. Our bishop tonight stands in the twofold office as priest and prophet.
Now, most people would wonder, what is this really for? Well, you know the favorite scripture we read out of the Psalms that says how good and how pleasant it is for brethren to dwell together in unity? For it is like the precious ointment that was poured upon the head of the priest that ran down his beard onto his apron. This means I got work to do. This covers me so that I don't operate in the flesh. But this is the assignment that says I've got work to do. And we know that there is work to be done. Now, when the anointing falls on him, it also falls on his work. That anybody that he begins to work with, the aroma of that fragrance, that anointing, may drip off on you because you are also parts of this workmanship. So when you see the apron, what you actually see is yourself, because we are the workmanship that's produced from the servant of the living God. Hallelujah.
Instrument of suffering on which Christ died and redeemed the world. It is symbolic for whatever pain and endurance that a Christian undergoes and voluntarily accepts in order to be joined with Christ and cooperate in the salvation of souls. If anyone wants to be a follower of mine, let him renounce himself and take up his cross and follow me. Matthew 16:24. The Bible. The Bible presented to the new bishop is a reminder of the charge to defend and proclaim the word of God. The ghetto. The small, round skull cap of the ecclesiastic worn under the beretta or mitre.
A lot of people would wonder, what is this little piece of material for? And why do them little Jewish boys, and why do these people wear these little things on their head? Well, it represents that they are students, and that they are forever learning, and that they are studying under God. We know that in this century, and for those of you that want to get away with it, you say that your hair was given to you as your glory and as a covering, it's a glory. Sure, it is a glory. But when you are seeking and when you are in the presence of the Lord, he says, I don't want to share the glory. I need mine for myself. So therefore, we cover ourselves. We cover ourselves. And saying that, I saw two or three women here today that have these little lace doilies on their head.
And I heard different people asking, what does that mean and what does that represent? It just simply means that I'm covered by God right now. I don't need my own. I'm covered by the glory of God. So therefore, I'll keep my glory hidden unto myself. When you're operating under God's glory and God's anointing, it's no secret. He said, what you do in secret, I'll reward you openly. It's no secret as to what God can do. Biblical requirements for ordaining as bishop. We, the ordination council, and we're going to ask Fivefold Ministry, you're standing front center looking good. Amen. Have given careful examination as to the moral character, soundness of doctrine, and leadership qualifications of this person for the work of the ministry. I do hereby award to you on this day from the New Christ Supernatural Temple of Deliverance Ministry here in Tacoma, Washington, on the 28th day of January in the year of our Lord 2012. I present to some, and we introduce to this great city, our Bishop Frederick Brown. So our first lady and our angel of this country, we ask you to come receive your husband. Before we do the house offering, we're going to ask our angel if she would, our first lady, Brother Deacon, bring him here in a chair. We want everybody to get something out, something special. I want you to see, make your first seat on this day. He will receive it at the apostles' feet, at the feet of them that labor. Come. We're going to ask ushers, amen. As I'm talking to you, let's stand on this side. Stand up, please, in obedience. and just come and drop and go before we take up the main altar. No, it's not in the basket, it's at his feet. Amen. Starting from the rear, is there an usher available to lead him out, please? Special seed, offer it. Yes, do this side first, son. Do this side first. Amen. Amen. Come on, get something in your hands. Oh, bless the Lord. Thank you. We thank you today. Amen. God bless. Come on, y'all. Let's get in there. I'm trying to get us out of here. Amen. All right, middle section, just come on out. Wherever you are, come on out over here. Just drop it. Amen. Crossover. Christ Temple. Better life. Greater apostolic. Thank you, Jesus. Our community, our friends. Thank you, Jesus. We thank God for these great churches that are here. To our First Lady, Dr. Rose, that's here. Amen. This is what makes our dear beloved bishop shine so great. He has an awesome woman of God that is right on his side. God bless each of you, children. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, bless your name. Bless your name. God bless you. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Those of you that have your tithes and offering, please see the finance of each of your churches. All that is given. To ask that our financial leaders of each ministry, we're going to ask our minister Rufus to come on up. We're going to ask, amen, Deacon Spruler standing. We're going to ask our minister Sally, amen, to come stand, amen, for our offering. Get our trays out. This has been a great day. We know what our responsibilities are for each ministry. Somebody said they put them away. We had new people, amen, trying to organize us, amen. God bless. Amen. We're going to ask each ministry, if you're a guest of the day, you drop it in any basket that you so desire. Amen. It was right over there in the corner last night, y'all. The sun. For each ministry that's represented in this building. God bless. There we go. There we go. We got it now. Each one of these are represented. Come on and bless today. We still have bills to pay. Is that all right? Amen. The church governs itself. I know it looks good in here, y'all. Come on, somebody. Amen. He said, bring your tithes and our offerings into the storehouse that they may be meet. Amen. We're going to now ask on this side of the house, if you would start from the rear. Come on and take another walk down Blessed Boulevard. Amen. From the rear, come pray your tithes and offering. Why don't you just stand? Amen. Touch the plates by faith. Amen. We're almost done. Amen. We're getting ready to go through our dinner and remarks. God bless you. good as our middle section. Come on, amen. We got a lot of training ahead of us. But please come on out. This is a dynamic hot spot where God has ordained to be. Amen. Our first service starts every Sunday morning at 10 a.m. Amen. The second service starts at 12:30. Amen. Our third service starts at 3:30. And then our last service of the evening, it is at 6 o'clock. Amen. We have 4 to 5 different great ministries that are going on. Amen. And I can guarantee you from every walk of life, amen, I can guarantee you that your time, amen, of service will be fulfilled. Amen. Have all given. God bless. We're going to ask that y'all turn this way. Amen. We're going to ask you, the audience, amen, that you point your hands, amen, towards them. Amen. We're going to ask, amen, our elder well, come and bless our giving.
Amen, Jesus. We ask that you look down upon this offering. You say it in your word, to bring ye all the tithes into the storehouse, so that there may be meat in my house. You said, try me and prove me now, if I will not open up the windows of heaven and pour you out a blessing where you will not have room enough to receive. Father, we ask in Jesus' holy mighty name that you bless these tithes and offering, Father God, that they may be used for the continuing upbuilding of your holy kingdom. In the mighty name of Jesus, bless the hands that gave, O God, and bless the hands that had not to give, O God. We praise and we glorify you, and we offer this up to you with the praise of thanksgiving. In Jesus' holy mighty name, we ask, pray, praise, bless, thank, and we love you, Abba. Thank God. Amen, amen, amen.
Amen. Amen. Come on, give God some praise. Please don't leave yet. We're almost there. What we were liking, amen, each of you to do. Amen. Just 1 second, dear. I got that. Amen. We are going to do something a little bit special. We're going to ask. We're almost down to the conclusion of the matter. Amen. And what we're going to ask is that we're asking everyone to go to our fellowship hall for at least maybe 30 minutes that we can set up, amen, here in the sanctuary, that we may have an awesome fellowship dinner, amen, where we want everyone to be able to sit down in comfort, amen, as we fellowship. So our goal is, after we services closing in just a few more minutes, after our remarks, we're going to ask you that you govern yourselves, amen. We need all men folk, if you can and will, those that can, amen, just wait around for a second or two to help, amen, while we go to another level in this place. Again, we want to say thanks to all, and I want a special thanks, amen, to this anointed, appointed man of God, amen. Put your hands together for this awesome moderator, for this great occasion. We bow to you for one great apostle to the next, amen. We love you and we thank you for being led by God, amen, handling this day. And to my co, amen, I praise and I thank God for this precious daughter of God. Y'all put your hands together for our own Pastor Wachia. Woo! Come on, give God some praise, amen. Thank you, Jesus. Give her another mic. Y'all be coming to another official service. Amen. She is our new elect apostle. Y'all ain't saying nothing. Honey, God has moved in this building, in this corner. Amen. While other folks are on the road trying to get to Seattle. Amen. We got the best right here in Lakewood. Come on and give God some praise. Hallelujah. We thank each of you. I've had some awesome pastors to work with. I'm telling you, we did all our little accolades on yesterday. Amen. But I want to say publicly, amen, to our First Lady, of this great work, our own angel of this great ministry, and the new call on her life, our own First Lady. Would you please stand? But we're trying to teach you under the apostolic call. You want to give honor where honor is due. From this day forth, when our bishop enters into the building, y'all ain't saying nothing. When the apostle enters into the building, y'all ain't saying nothing. When our pastors are entering the building, amen, we ought to give God all the praise and glory. We're not worshiping man, but the word of God said that we ought to give honor. God bless you. You may be seated. Amen. And two, our fine deacons. Amen. I wouldn't know what to do without my deacon Sproul. Amen. He is the chairman, amen, of the Christ Supernatural Temple of Deliverance Ministries. Y'all give God some praise for my deacon. This movement of God that God has moved upon, amen, it's not just about crossover, amen. And that's what I like, what, amen, new-elect bishop, amen, has renounced, amen, and declared, amen, that crossover now done have came out of Egypt. Oh, my God. I'm not here to preach because we're going to move on, amen. But I'm telling y'all it's a new day, and every one of our ministries, amen, that fellowship, all I can tell you about this house, amen, all the prayers and the anointing that went forth, and to our Bishop Smith and to our First Lady, A. Smith, y'all give God some praise. Yeah. Amen. For our missionary mother, God bless you. Amen. For being here. Amen. We know sometimes our ceremonies, believe it or not, y'all, this is good on time. We the last one out of 10. We went in at 3. At 9 o'clock, they were still going. I had to go. Amen. But I tell you, I thank each of you for your love, your prayers, endless hours. Amen. Of interceding for others, amen, to this young man, Brother Tyler, amen, we praying for you. God's getting ready to do some new things in you, sir, hey, because there's a word that is in you, amen, and we just thank God. We got a lot of wonderful things that will be coming through. Please, amen, continue to keep us in your prayers. Again, I thank each and everyone. I don't want to feel like I'm leaving anybody out, from the doorkeepers, amen, to each and everywhere, to our armor bearer. Y'all stand up, our sister Claritha. I want to say this because she is in training, amen. And she is one of those, she reminds me of my deacon, amen. It's not where that is just Pastor Wajita's armor bearer, which she, God has given, but at the same time, a heart to serve God's people. And I honor you and I bow unto you on this holy day. God bless you, amen. All righty. So at this time, amen, our call. Is there anything else that I forgot before we turn it over to our new elect bishop? Amen. You want to say something? You're kind of quiet there. Amen. Come on, baby girl. Go put your hands together for our pastor. Amen.
Bishop Brown, I thank God for his wife, a beautiful woman that sometimes misunderstood, but someone that I know that loves the Lord with all of her heart. She loves God's people. And she loves her husband. And she loves family. Not only her family, but she loves other families too. And when we do these, I'm gonna get out of the way, but when we do these is, you know, it is his day, but it wouldn't be a him if it wasn't a her. Because sometimes wives have to stand in the gap. And sometimes they're the closest to the leader, sometimes be the first people that get it when things just ain't going right or something needs to happen. That sometimes that's the first person that we sometimes raise our voice to. Or we get upset because something ain't right. But I'm here to tell you, one pastor to another, one woman of God to another, one sister to sister, I commend you. And I thank you for being the strong woman. Come on, give her real. Give her some real praise. Okay, you know you my brother, my friend. So you know, as you know, I love you. I love you, Pastor Brown. No, I'm sorry, Bishop Brown. I love you. Don't y'all talk about Bishop Brown. I love him. So, no, I just thank God for today. And I thank God for you, my sister.
Amen. Just take your seats for a second. I ain't said that all night.
Amen. Amen.
You know, I came here actually as an act of faith. You know, everybody got their struggles and their trials and their glory. But I just wanted to let my husband know I'm proud of you. I thank God for you. I'm praying for you all the time. I believe in you.
Give God some glory in the house tonight. Come on, let's give God some glory in the house tonight. I mean, God did some great things in this house tonight. Come on, church. I said, give God some glory. I didn't say, give me no glory. I said, give God some praise in the house tonight. I tell you, you know, I didn't think I was going to make it here tonight. But I thank God. And no one can never tell me there's not a God. I know there's a God. It's too late right now. You should have got me. You should have got me early, but it's too late now. I have seen the goodness and the testimony of what God can do in someone's life if only you can believe. I tell you, it's been a long road here. I know there's a lot of work to do. Church, I tell you, we're running out the gate tomorrow. because there's a lot of things that's going on in this nation here today. And we've been asleep for a long time, but I'm telling you, we need to come out of those closets, because the Lord has said, look, get up off your knees and stop praying to me about the things that I've already told you to do, and go and do those things, because this nation is in a shuffles because we have been quiet too long. But I'm telling you, we see all these things going on around here. I tell you, the world has just got this place flipped all upside down. But I'm telling you, I know that prayer works. And they try to make it seem like prayer does not work, but the devil is alive. We know it works, and we're going to get on about God's business out there. You know, we get in church and we just shout, and we shout till our heels come off, and then we leave out here and do nothing. But I'm telling you, talk is over. It's time to put some work to that talk so that we can get out there and take this city back. We're going to take our families back. We're going to take our kids back. We're going to heal marriages out there. And we're not going to allow the devil to come in and destroy things, because we know the word of God is powerful than anything on this earth. And we need to start acting like it, stop treating God's word like it's nothing. I tell you, the world is out there. You know, they're coming in here with all the same-sex marriages and all those things while we have been asleep. But I'm telling you, it's not going to happen in this house. It's not going to happen in this house, because what God has set in order, we're going to enforce. And if you're with me, let's give God a hand clap in this house for today. I tell you, you know, I'm not inciting a riot, but I am inciting a Holy Ghost riot. And I tell you, it's about time for the men and women of God to stand up and take their rightful place and to begin to decree and declare things that we need to start speaking life and death into those dead situations out there and start calling it like God called it. I tell you, we've been quiet too long. We've been quiet too long, church, I'm telling you. A lot of us have cried and prayed, and we almost at the point of giving up. But I'm telling you, don't give up. There is hope on the way, because as long as there's hope and as long as there's expectation, God can move. But when you give up, there is no hope. But I'm telling you, we may have failed, but I'm telling you, the difference between success and failure is getting up one less time then you fail. Amen. Come on, give God some glory in this house. I say, give God some glory in this house. Church, we need to start reverencing God like we should. And we just shouldn't need no one to pump you up. I tell you, we need to get back to when the man of God stand up. I mean, the people just start shouting because they know that there's a word from the Lord. I tell you, I'm sick and tired of just talking. I'm not talking anymore. For all those that are ready to take our city back, to take our families back, our kids, our school, you need to get up and start shouting right now. Because this is a testimony of what's going to happen here in this nation. Because I'm tired. I'm tired of all the things that are going on, because I know God's word is powerful. I know deep down in my heart that God's word is powerful, but we got to believe. We got to believe. We got to move from the point I'm just thinking God would do it to knowing that God would do it. And I'm telling you, church, we can do it. And the word of God says we can do all things through Christ who give us the strength. We need to get self out of there and put God back on the throne so we can get about God's business. Church, one thing that I do know is that, you know, I found something that I'm willing to die for. And I'm telling you, until you found something that you're willing to die for, you're not ready to live. You just existed. Because I'm telling you, each and every person was put on this earth for a purpose. And when you, until you realize what that purpose is, you are not living life. And I'm telling you, I'm tired of people just existing, just going through the motion, talking about we gonna do it, and then if leave there and we go home like nothing ever happened. But I'm telling you, those days are over. I decree those days are over right now in the name of Jesus. And whatsoever thing you decree shall
be established. So I decree right now, this day, this Sunday, this day, mark it, that this nation gonna begin to turn around. And it ain't gonna happen just by talk. We gonna have to get about God's business, and we gonna have to take it one city and one state at a time. And I need you to intercede. I need you to intercede. I need you to turn your plate down, because it's something about when we turn our plate down that God tend to just show up more clearly. Some of us haven't heard God in a while, but I'm telling you, you need to turn your plate down and get back to where God said get, and he will meet you there. Church, this is our city. This is our city. And we're going to take it by force. That's the word of God. It says the kingdom of God suffered violence, and the violence take it by force. Honey, I thank God for you. One thing that I always know, even when you think there is no hope, even when you think there is no hope, there is. Because when you put things in God's hand and get self out of the way, God can move. God can move. And I'm telling you, there's a lot of us out there believing God for something that we're about at the point of giving up. But I'm standing here today to tell you to continue to press your way, because there's no testimony in saying I quit. But the testimony is saying, you know what, I was almost about to give up, but thank goodness to God, I decided to pray one more time. I decided to just press one more time. And look what God has done. And I'm telling you, it can happen. And it will happen. Because we decree it, because our words is power. We're going to speak life into these dead situations, because there's a lot of dead things out there. And I decree right now, it is done. It's decreed in Jesus' name, it will be done. We need to get away from just playing church. Because I'm telling you, we've been playing church a long time. We ain't seen no manifestation. We ain't seen no lives being changed. I mean, people coming in and leaving the same way. But the devil is alive. When they walk through the door, the anointing should hit them. Because if there's anything in here, they should be changed when they leave here. Time out for that. People's lives will be changed. Not because of what I say, but because of God's word speaking through me says it will be done. It will be done. We need to come on up here and stand with me. I'm thinking, give it up. Amen. Well, I just have to walk with me. I'm gonna tell you, I'm gonna be one of those bishops that's unorthodox. If y'all expecting me to play by those rules, it ain't happening. This is the 2012 bishop, and we doing things totally different. We out of the box. Ain't no one putting me in no box, so don't even try. Because when the Lord speak, I'm moving. And if I got to move by myself, it'll be me and him. Because I know me and him is more than enough. Amen. So we're not preaching today.
After we take the 30 minutes when they set up, we're going to have some singing and any other gifts at that time. But at this time, let's receive, amen, our new elect bishop and our queen and our first lady. And we're going to ask that the Presbyterian board follows up. May we have some music. Stand right here. They're going to greet you, and we're going to just take our time. The only one, the Presbyterian board, all of us, please come and march in. Come on, minister. Come on, all our ministers.
Faithful.
Pastor Wajito, hope.